r/AskReddit. What is society doing now that in 20 years will be laughed at and ridiculed? High consumption of added sugars. This was gonna be mine. I think we'll look at people who drink lots of sodas in 20 years like we look at cigarette smoker today. Sodas and energy drinks. Thank you. I personally couldn't believe how much sugar is in some things once I started looking at labels. It's insane. Some things don't even need an extra 30 grams of added sugar. Facebook. Well, we can only hope. Maybe YouTube. Too. Something's coming for it, and I don't know if it will survive. Hopefully, they didn't seem to realize that the reason people liked it was the freedom they used to give to their contributors. Greed killed it. For example, video game walkthroughs. I used to go to YouTube to find quick walkthroughs for things like finding collectibles or defeating a boss. Now everyone makes every video long as shit to give advertising their time. Just show me where the shit is on the in-game map. Dongs. 3 minutes tops. Yep, things like the ads and the demonetization is really getting to some viewers and YouTubers. It's like there is kids and family YouTube for a reason. Honestly, they should make tags for your video like family-friendly, mature audiences and toxic. That way you know what you're getting into, and obviously if you mark the video the wrong way you get demonetized. Social media influencers. I laugh about it now. There is a bit of an outcry in Australia at the moment. Instagram have apparently turned off the like feature. So these so-called influencers are having a whinge that it's going to affect their revenue because no one will see how many likes they get. I think it's hilarious. Wait, this update is only in Australia? I've been sitting here thinking it's worldwide. Haven't noticed the difference, I'll be honest. I think they've only rolled it out in 3 countries so far to test it. Here in the States we still have like counts. I really hope it's how little we understand about diseases, how to cure them. Edit. My uncle just died from cancer at 49. His best friend was his son. They lived together in a small house after his wife left. He died a few weeks before his graduation. They used to play games and drink beer together. His son's eulogy was the most gut-wrenchingly sad and upsetting thing I've ever seen or heard. Ambitious maybe, but a little bit of optimism and hope shouldn't go amiss. We understand a lot about cancer, and in fact a lot of people that study cancer are surprised that more people don't die from it more often. It's really fascinating to read about. Sorry for your loss. The main problem that we still face with cancer is that there are so many different kinds that each respond a little differently to treatment. Some are dealt with fairly simply with chemo and or radiation, but others we still haven't figured out how to destroy yet. The main problem is that we can't afford time and money to tailor a medical treatment plan for each cancer patient, which is what must be the norm in the future hopefully. That's also true, but there's still a huge difference between, say, germinoma and glioblastoma. One is very sensitive to radiation and some forms of chemo, the other is basically a death sentence. Photoshopping themselves. I feel like this is actually going to get more common and simpler too. With AI being developed into the photo mod apps, it's going to be almost natural. Hopefully throwing cigarette butts on the ground. It should be looked at as if someone is throwing a bottle on the ground. It's always blew my mind that filters aren't biodegrade. Like, when everyone smoked without them, whatever they threw away would eventually disappear. Now that shit stays around for ages forever. I feel like the manufacturers of cigarettes care as much about the environment as they do their consumers' health. Smoking cigarettes at all? It's funny to read sci-fi novels from the 1960s and 1970s. For example, Heinlein or Dong. They assume that with more money in a technologically advanced version of the 1960s, everyone in 2150 will chain smoke and drink scotch during the day. Already in 2019. Smoking rates are about 1/3 of the 1960s, and drinking liquor during the workday is seen as problem drinking by most people. I doubt that very many people will smoke in 100 years. Being anti-vaxxers. I mean, we laugh at that already, but you know. We'll be laughing because they'll be dead. The unfortunate kids will be dead. Pretty sure most anti-vaxxers were already vaxxed as kids, so they'll still be healthy sort of. Can almost guarantee today's fashion will be. Hey, that is cheating. You can say that about basically any era. It always comes back around. Fashion is very much cyclical. It might not be as extreme as it used to be, but let me tell you, I've seen numerous people in the city walking around in Baby Spice platform shoes. Fanny packs and butterfly clips and scrunchies are all the rage amongst my middle school students, and I find it baffling. Minion memes. Paying for Wi-Fi. I don't know if 20 years is a good timeline for that. Both SpaceX and Blue Origin have plans for satellite constellations to provide basically worldwide Wi-Fi, but they are meant to be revenue generators to fund some of their more ambitious, less profitable missions. Maybe 50 years. Going hugely in debt for degrees because of the myth that you need a college education to be successful in life. Hopefully trades become accepted in the future. Electricians and plumbers will always be necessary. More people would go into the trades if more contractors treated their guys well. If the culture of casual racism, sexism and all-round apprentice abuse ended, more people would go into the trades. It is not that young people are not interested, it is that they are not interested in being yelled at by some old alcoholic dunt. People are expected to work like ducking dogs in the skilled trades by a-holes who will lay them off without a second notice just because. For shite pay, little to no benefits, and no pension. Obviously union is a little different. I'm an electrician. I work more engineering, automation, controls, PLCS etc. I ducking hate construction trades because of the people. I dunno how much longer this is going to be applicable. A lot of the area trade schools by me are catching on to the fact that many are choosing trades over traditional college and are charging more for tuition and books than ever before. It's not going to be a one simple trick to avoid student debt forever. It's hard to say because we tend to look back on things and think that all of them are ridiculous. But most likely insta model culture? I just can't imagine that 20 years from now we won't look back at those skinny tea or whatever posts and not think, wow, why would anyone ever do this? There has always been some version of this in every time period. Hopefully, ignoring climate change. No laughter because everyone is gone. Hopefully, toxic internet fandom. It is escalating so fast these days that I think it will reach a crescendo at some point. And these people will look back on all the time they spent reading articles about every detail of the life of their idols and poisoning the well for whatever person the media, and sometimes the celebrities themselves, decide is their direct rival as something to regret and mocked. There have always been super fans. But internet forums, comment sections, and social media seem to have focused and amplified the most toxic part of this. Pretty soon, internet sites just won't tolerate too much bullshit anymore, and even the celebrities will see how bad it is all around. I mean, when singers, drag queens, and athletes are getting death threats from random people on a regular basis, this really isn't sustainable. Working 9-5. I wish. But I don't see people worrying too much yet. I wish the normal work schedule would be less. Area 51 raid. I remember it like it was yesterday. The Russians made thousands of Americans raid Area 51 as a joke, but the Americans were too gullible and thousands lost their lives. Unprecedented, I tell you. I feel like getting Americans to do stupid shit is an international sport to the infowar departments of the rest of the world. Treating homeless people like inhuman scum, or the giant money-making industrial complex that the modern prison system has become. I'm not sure if people will be laughing at these things or looking at them like we look at slavery and the treatment of indigenous peoples. Everyone glorifying the diaper ass that Kim Kardashian made popular. Those tiny glasses. Yes, we absolutely should drink our vodka out of pint glasses. Making cats into six-figure celebrities, including inviting them to public appearances and talk shows, costing them in commercials and movies, flying them all over the country world for appearances, and then later watching them die fairly young from all of the stress of being flown around the country world, passed around to various strangers, and handled by thousands of people hoping to get a selfie with a celebrity cat. Oh, and don't forget doping them up for every one of these appearances so they don't get anxious. Using a car that isn't self-driving. Probably won't be laughed at. They'll be like, how the hell did they do it? So much could go wrong. Hopefully chemotherapy. I had chemo last year. I'd probably be dead, or dying, if I didn't have it. It's shit, but if the alternative is death, I choose chemo, unless I'm 80 or something. then it's not really worth going through it. Child drag shows. Child beauty pageants as well. The sheer amount of carbon and non-reusable plastics we pumped onto the earth from underground. Sharing basically our whole lives online. It's considered socially acceptable now for the most part, but I can't think of any other period in time where pretty much everyone put a large portion of their private lives on display. Allowing kids to undergo hormone therapy to change their gender. Sure, they can't drink or get a tattoo, but let's let them make a life-altering decision. Supporting and funding animal abuse exclusively for pleasure. Real housewife type shows. The fact that people find these type of show entertaining or something honorable should be laughable now and will be laughable in 20 years. PC culture. It's true. Anytime someone shows off their new battle station, it always looks like an RGB unicorn threw up all over their bedroom. Toxic politics. I just want there to be civil discourse about things that matter and can be factually proven, not based on feelings and stuff that we can't believe. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.